During the early part of the century, there were many African Americans who gained national and international attention. Many of them were contemporaries of Nannie Helen Burroughs, a noted orator who traveled the world and gave her life to the betterment of all people.
More than 50 years before Martin Luther King's famous line at the March on Washington about the content of character versus the color, she talked, Nannie Helen Burroughs wrote a paper where she talked about character and not color.
Nannie Helen Burroughs lived and worked in the Deanwood community of Northeast Washington.
Nannie Helen Burroughs was born in Orange County, Virginia to John Burroughs and Jenny Poindexter on May 2, 1879. Nannie's grandfather was a slave.
10-year-old DeCarlos Young is one of the many students at the Nannie Helen Burroughs School. The school was originally known as the National Training School for Girls and Women, but was later changed to honor its founder. Rita Johnson is the principal.
Girls learned domestic professions, laundry, hair, printing, typing, those kinds of things, entrepreneurships. Well, now we're doing standards-based curriculum here at Nannie Helen Burroughs School.
Nannie Helen Burroughs' lifetime dream was born out of a personal setback. Called crazy by her closest friends, Miss Burroughs moved the earth with her own two hands to make her dream a reality. Her savvy and determination was admired by many.
This just gives you an idea of how powerful, of how much foresight Nannie Helen Burroughs had, and how she was able to marshal not only her formidable energy, but those of people around her to create an institution that lasted many decades beyond her own life.
Nannie Helen Burroughs' legacy lives in the lives of those who have been affected by her knowledge and guidance. She is recognized as a champion and provides inspiration. She takes her rightful place along the African-American Heritage Trail.